Many people, myself included for a while, assume that women have a higher tolerance for pain because, well, we give birth. But science actually tells us a completely different story. Hi guys and gals, Lisette here for DNews. Now, I'm sorry, but it's true. Research shows that men have both a higher pain tolerance and higher threshold for pain. In studies, women typically report feeling pain much sooner than men. And women also tell experimenters to stop the pain that's being inflicted on them much sooner than men do. And this all comes from data analyzed in multiple studies that spanned a period of more than a decade, many of which have been published in the Journal of Pain. Now, researchers study pain using all kinds of torturous methods. Some of the more common ways they inflict pain on participants include putting really cold things directly on the skin, administering electric shocks, and putting a lot of physical pressure on different parts of the participant's body. In one study at the University of Lincoln in the UK, researchers subjected 24 men and 26 women to cold presses and measured their responses. Consistent with other studies, they found that women had a lower tolerance and lower threshold for pain compared to men. But the scientists took the study even further. When the researchers told the participants to focus on the physical components of the pain, it helped decrease the pain felt for men, but not for women. And when they asked them to focus on the emotional aspects of the pain, it made the pain feel worse for women, but not for men. So for women, it's like a double whammy. They seem to feel more pain more quickly and have a harder time coping with it too. But what's important to keep in mind is that most of these studies rely on self-reports, which means they are susceptible to biases. Pain is largely defined by science as subjective. We rely on people to tell us how much pain they feel and when they feel it, as opposed to measuring it more directly, like we do with height or weight. Not surprisingly, studies have found that social factors influence these reports of pain and the gender difference we see. In one study published in Cross-Cultural Research on college students from both India and the US, researchers found that Americans were more willing to express that they're in pain than their Indian counterparts. And this was reflected in how much pain they reported. American students tolerated less pain than Indian students, meaning that both sets of students could have been feeling the same pain, but for cultural reasons, one group expressed it quicker than the other. On top of that, things like who's conducting the experiment seem to matter too. In another recent study published in the journal Pain, researchers had 80 male and 80 female participants put their hands in icy cold water to measure their tolerance. But the researchers split the participants so half of them had the test conducted by someone of the same sex and half had someone of the opposite sex. The study found that how long they kept their hand underwater significantly varied depending on whether the experimenter was a man or a woman. If tested by the opposite sex, they lasted much longer. Clearly, there are mediating social factors that influence pain. But this doesn't mean biology doesn't play a role too. Another study published in the journal Pain measured pain not by asking the participants how much pain they felt, but by measuring how their pupils behaved with infrared technology. Researchers hypothesized that the amount the pupil dilated directly correlated with how much pain they were in. In conditions of high pressure or pain, women's pupils dilated much more than men's. This matters because it's not like the participants could manipulate how much their pupils were dilating. This is a completely involuntary biological reaction. So it might just be that men and women feel pain differently. But some men and women don't feel pain at all. Find out why in this video.
Nerve cells communicate by sodium ions. As these ions get passed through channels from one cell to the next, the pain signals travel from the injury site where it's felt up the spinal cord and into the brain. But a mutation in the SCN9A gene stops these channels called NaV1.7 channels from forming.
So what do you think about the research? Do you have any qualms? Let us know in the comments below and remember to subscribe to DNews for more episodes.